Almost everyone with vitiligo patches on their body often wonder about one thing. What if someday their entire body gets covered with vitiligo and they become just white overall? Maybe it's not that bad of an outcome, but most of them don't know if it is even possible, and if it is possible, how to make that happen. Hello guys, I'm Sanjay Chandel, and in today's episode, I'm going to give you an overview of the full body depigmentation therapy as one of the most successful ways to get rid of the patchy look of vitiligo, that too on a permanent basis. So let's begin this episode of my new channel, The Vitiligo Experience. I will be briefly covering some of the important points in this episode, such as what is Depig therapy? Why do you need it? Are you a good candidate? Pros and cons, how to depig, and is it really that simple? So let's dive in. So what is Depig therapy? Full body depigmentation therapy, or in short Depig therapy, means to remove the original pigment or brown color from your normal skin to match it with your white vitiligo skin. For example, if you look at this hand, this is full of vitiligo patches. But then, if you remove the brown color from the normal skin around the vitiligo patches, and if you now look at this hand, all the patchiness is gone, and the hands looks quite normal, except that now the hands looks very pale, as if it belongs to a white man who never goes out in the sun at all. Now, if you take the same process and applies to whole of your body, it is known as full body depigmentation therapy. Next question is, why do you need it? The simple answer to this question is, you don't. It is also the reason most dermatologists do not prescribe it for you. It is not a medical necessity. It is also a reason that most of the medical insurance companies refuse to reimburse it. Then why there is so much interest in this? The reason is quite simple. People want to look good and feel normal again. Most of them, and I include myself, have suffered decades of emotional pain and psychological trauma that people go through if they have extensive amount of visible vitiligo patches on their body. For them, it is an ideal solution. In short, it is a perfect cosmetic solution to a disfiguring cosmetic problem. For me personally, it has been a perfect solution. I did it in 2007 and it changed my life forever. For the better, of course. I don't even remember having vitiligo anymore and have absolutely no regrets about it. Since 2008, I have tried to guide more than 100 people in person and on social media with every kind of emotional support and resources they needed to go through this process, with the combined experience of myself and of others who went through this complete therapy and successfully depigmented. So now, am I a right candidate for Depig? This is the very first question that needs to be answered before you get too much interested in Depig therapy. Now, there is no specific answer to this question, but the most common thumb rule is that if you have extensive vitiligo covering more than 50% of your body, and there is no real chance that you will ever be able to get back your lost skin color, then you are a suitable candidate for Depig therapy. The keyword here is extensive. It means that you have lost full or partial pigment on more than half of your body. Now, I'm not saying that more than 50% of your skin should already be white. What I'm saying is that your vitiligo should have at least made an impression on most of your body. For example, if you have vitiligo spots on your hands, wrists, feet, legs, face, lips, necks, and genitals, but you have no spots on back, thighs, or stomach, you would still qualify for Depig therapy. Who is not a right candidate for Depig? People who have few spots only on face or other fleshy areas. These are the areas which respond very well to the repigmentation therapy, and there is absolutely no need to take an extreme measure such as Depig to treat those spots. Also, children below 12 years, pregnant ladies, and mothers who are still nursing small babies are also not the right candidate for this. Because the chemical used for Depig therapy is a very strong chemical and can mess up the developing immune system and skin pigmentation in unborn and young children. So if you're breastfeeding your baby, don't even think about it. It's a definite no-go. Let's discuss the pros and cons of the Depig therapy now. First, let's start with the pros. Number one, you get a uniform white skin color and your vitiligo patches are not visible anymore. You have no idea how much of a big relief this is for someone who has vitiligo through 10, 15, 20 or even 30 years. It's a life-changing process and very few people, if any, will actually regret it. Number two, no more repigmentation therapy frustrations. No more expensive phototherapy. No need to get pills or cream which suppresses your immune system. No more dealing with frustrations, which is inevitable if you lose the pigment that you get back after spending a lot of time and your hard-earned money after just 1 month of stopping your repig treatment. Number three, no more hiding behind makeup. No more concealers. No more heavy foundation to hide your uneven skin tone. No more brown collars of white shirts and tops. It's a huge relief. Number four, you don't have to follow any diet restrictions anymore. You can eat whatever you want, whenever you want. Number five, every color looks good on you. You can do a lot of experiments with the new look that you have, with your clothes, with your style, with your makeup, your hair color, your accessories. A whole new world will open for you to explore. Now coming to the cons. Number one, you will never be able to tan. If you go out in the sun, you will just get red and burn. You could take fake tanning products, but most people get used to their new white skin after a while. Number two, you will not have any protection from sun. Your skin pigment has just one function, to protect you from ultraviolet rays of the sunlight. The darker your skin color is, the better protected you are from sunlight. With Depig therapy, you reach the palest of pale colors found in human beings. This means you will need to wear sunblock whenever you step out in the sun. And you anyway need to reduce your sun exposure to like the minimum possible limit. You cannot go out to the beach or park for picnic and remain in the sun throughout the day. The most difficult would be to go out on vacations where you would have to be real careful. Number three, you will lose benefit of the sun. Sunlight provides you with many health benefits, such as vitamin D, and it has other healing properties throughout its UVB spectrum. And you will be missing out on those. You will definitely have to take vitamin D supplements throughout your life. Number four, repigmentation spots. Since many of us find it difficult to avoid sun, some of us would find ourselves with small brown freckles, known as repig spots. Now, these spots are normally dark brown pigment, which if left without treatment, can become difficult to get rid of at a later stage. Number five, perception of loss of identity. If you have black and dark brown skin, and suddenly in a short span of time, you turn into a white man or woman, some people around you may start questioning your motives, thinking that you deliberately chose to lighten your skin because you hated your old skin color. Now, the reality is that you are still you, even with a new skin. But people's perception towards you can change a lot, which you will have to probably deal with. Now, these are the discussions for a later episode where I will go deep with these topics. But for intro, I think these points should do. Let me know in the comments below if you feel there are more pros and cons after Depig. I will be happy to include them in the future videos and share it with my audience. So now coming to the most important question of all. How do you start and finish your Depig therapy? The very first step is to find a dermatologist who will listen to your Depig request, hopefully with some compassion, check if you are a suitable candidate, and if yes, he will write you a prescription for a depigmentation cream and advise you how to use it. He will also probably ask you for a test application first, where you will apply this on a small area of your body to check if there is any immediate allergic reactions or anything. If there is no immediate allergic reaction, he will most likely start you to begin with 20% monobenzone cream to be used as prescribed by him. He will also ask you to regularly visit him on a monthly basis to check your progress. Now, to fill your prescription, the doctor may send you to a pharmacy who will custom make this cream for you, or he will give you a source from where you can buy the cream. The process of depigmentation is actually not difficult at all, especially if you already have a lot of vitiligo patches spread around your body. The therapy involves regular application of a depigmentation agent cream, usually monobenzone, to the areas of your skin where you want to lose the pigment. You will start seeing the fading of the skin color within few weeks, and you just need to continue this treatment till there is no pigment left in your body and your whole body has a uniform white color. One of the best things about this therapy is that you lose the color gradually and you don't get new vitiligo spots. So how many times a day I need to apply? Well, apply twice a day if you can, one time in the morning and one time in the evening, but minimum is once a day. Now, how much time it will take for you to finish the Depig therapy? Now, this question does not have a fixed answer. The average is between 6 months to 2 years. Now, there are people who react very quickly and be done in like 4 or 5 months. And there are also people who could take like more than 3 years, but those are extreme cases. The time it takes depends on several factors, such as how much vitiligo you have, is your vitiligo spreading or stable at that moment? It definitely depends on your original skin color. If you are a Caucasian, light brown, dark brown, or black skin person, the lighter your original skin is, the quicker the progress will be because the treatment has less pigment to kill. It could also depend whether you have any diseases which are commonly associated with vitiligo, such as hypothyroid, pernicious anemia, or celiac disease. The normal graph of progress in people who take more than a year is very similar. The progress is quick and impressive in first 4 to 6 months, and then it slows down and goes slowly as it eventually takes like 12 or 18 months or so. Is it really that simple? Okay. So here I talked about the ideal scenario where everything goes your way. You get a cooperative and compassionate dermatologist who listens to you, agrees with you, writes you a prescription, and also helps you arrange the Depig cream. And everything else goes as planned. While it may be a dream come true for some selected individuals, it's not that simple and straightforward for majority of the people across the world. Many of them just don't find a dermatologist who agrees with them. Even if he does, there is no way he can help them with procuring the cream because he doesn't know a compounding pharmacy who can make it for them. And they cannot find it at a regular pharmacy or even online because it is banned in their countries. If they somehow get hold of the cream through some shady online sites, it may not work for them and give them some unpleasant and unexpected results. We will talk about how to deal with and overcome these problems in future episodes and also share some tips and tricks to support you through this process. Now, I can talk for hours on this subject, but then the video will be too long. So my plan is to upload smaller video discussing one topic at one time. So do subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon so you will get a notification when I upload a new video. Also, don't forget to press the like button if you actually like this video. It will help me to know if I'm doing the right thing. I will see you in my next video. Ciao.